We've been following the Jussie Smollett saga for more than 3 weeks now, and it's been full of twists and turns.
The alleged attack happens in the early morning hour of January 29th.
A dozen detectives are working around the clock investigating an alleged racial and homophobic attack on Empire actor Jussie Smollett. So far, there's no description of the people who allegedly attacked the 36-year-old who plays Jamal Lyon on the TV show.
The following day, January 30th, Chicago police release photos of two people of interest they want to question. Police say there's no video of the actual attack. February 1st, Smollett issues his first statement, saying his account has always been consistent.
The Empire actor disputes social media rumors that he hasn't been cooperative with police. Smollett telling Essence magazine he's been 100% factual and consistent on every level and believes justice will be served.
Fast forward to February 12th. Police say Smollett turned over some of his phone records, hoping to corroborate his account of the attack. Police say some parts were left out and ultimately didn't help. February 14th. Police say they're speaking to the two people of interest, two brothers from Nigeria. Smollett gives his first and only television interview to Good Morning America, adamant that he's telling the truth.
Number one, I want them to find the people that did it. Number two, I want them to stop being able to say alleged attack. Number three, I want them to see that I fought back.
The following day, February 15th, police released the two brothers, saying they are not suspects. February 16th, amidst growing skepticism, police sources begin telling reporters they're more certain it was a hoax and Smollett may have paid the brothers to stage the attack. February 20th, police officially classify Smollett as a suspect, pointing to grand jury testimony from the two brothers, along with detective work and piles of video.
It's the video that changed everything. The men in it, brothers who know Jussie Smollett and who've told their story to prosecutors and police. It is, sources say, a much different tale than the one the 36-year-old Empire star has been telling since the early morning hours of January 29th, when he says he was jumped by two men near his home in Streeterville.
Charges are later filed against Smollett for filing a false police report.